Hey everyone, it's Jessica and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be talking about how I made this solar tracking system, including how I was able to assemble it together and program it. Before we get started, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to see more videos like these from me in the future. Without further ado, let's get started. To start off, these are all the materials I'll be using. The most notable items include the solar panel itself, the metal parts that will later become the stand for the solar panel, and the light-dependent resistors, or LDR modules, that track light. All of these and anything else I use in this video will be linked down below in the description box. After gathering all of my materials, I could start to put everything together. Here's a time-lapse of me assembling the entire solar panel tracking system. Thank you. After I finished setting everything up, I started the coding section of this project. This is the Arduino program I'm using. As you can see here, the first thing I did was include the Servo library and create a new Servo object called Servo1. Underneath that, I created a couple of variables and also assigned analog 0 and analog 3 to sensor pin 1 and sensor pin 2. In the setup function, I have the baud rate set to 9600 and my Servo1 variable is attached to pin 9. In the second function, I have a for loop that runs for a set number of times, which in my case is 10, and adds up the values from my LDR modules, which I then find the average value of by dividing by that same set number of 10. Those values are then printed out for me to see. I do this because the LDR modules are incredibly sensitive, and the values of them are always changing, even when they are under what seems to be a constant light brightness. So this helps establish an average of those values, which will later help my if-else statements that are right below. The if-else statements determine if the servo should turn based on whether or not one sensor is greater than the other sensor by a set number called threshold, and also which direction and how much it should turn. Besides the code, I also had to wire everything together. I showed some photos already, but this is what the entire wiring setup looks like. To start, I have two LDRs, each of which have two wires. This first LDR is connected to the breadboard, one wire going to the positive red, and the other going to the same row as a resistor in one of the analog pins. This is the same for the second LDR, where one wire goes to positive red, while the other connects with the resistor in another analog pin. As you can see on the breadboard, the resistors that I mentioned before both have one end connected to the negative blue. And for the analog pins that I mentioned before, the first one is connected to A0 and the second one is connected to A3. Also on the Arduino board, there are wires connecting 5 volts and ground to the positive red and the negative blue on the breadboard respectively. On the other side of my solar panel, I have my servo motor, which has 3 wires. The brown wire connects to the negative blue on the breadboard, the red wire connects to the positive red on the breadboard, while the orange one connects to pin 9 on the Arduino board. That's an overview of my wiring situation. I'll also insert a diagram on the screen right now with all that information in case mine was a little too confusing to look at and understand. Once everything's plugged in and the code's uploaded to the solar tracking system, we're done. And this is the final result. Here you can see the solar tracker and program working together. As you can see, the solar tracking system works as intended, moving in the direction where there is more light. Thank you. That's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this, and don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share this video. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!